Ripple traffic, Golf, 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 Tango Romeo, lining up runway 02, immediate departure. Hi everyone and welcome back. This is episode 19 of the Arctic Flying Expo 2023. And you are joining us with around 50 miles left to complete on our amazing journey. We had an interesting day yesterday as we were grounded due to bad weather once again. We spent the morning fixing the hangar door so that we could get our aircraft inside safely. Today the wind is still quite strong, but it has calmed down enough for us to complete our journey. If you have just stumbled across this video, please take the time to go back to episode 1 and watch the whole story unfold. If you have watched the whole series, I would like to thank you for sticking with me until the end. It is nearly 12 months since we set off, and I am just putting the last episode together. I have to say, I didn't realise the amount of time that it takes to work through all of the video footage and do my best to make something kind of watchable. But we got there in the end. There has been many times while putting the videos together that has put a lump in my throat. Sometimes due to the stunning scenery that Scandinavia has to offer, and other times due to the challenging circumstances that you find yourself in, generally brought on by the weather. It has to be said that the Flexwing Microlight is a highly proficient aircraft, capable of taking you to some amazing places. They have been flown from the UK to Australia, up into the Arctic, over the summit of Everest, and they have even circumnavigated the world. With the wind in your face and the 360 degree view, they are an amazing platform to take you on your adventures. By the time we get back to Deenethorpe, we will have flown over 18 countries, albeit some of them twice. We did 35 airfield landings and flew 4,864 miles. The strongest headwind we faced was a 45 mile an hour wind, and our highest ground speed achieved was 115 miles an hour. When we set out on this expedition, we had four goals. Number one was to fly from Deenethorpe to the North Cape of Norway. Number two was to circumnavigate the Baltic Sea. Number three was to return safely. And number four was to raise as much awareness and as much money for Prostate Cancer UK. And at this point, we have raised £8,133 for Prostate Cancer UK. Of course, this was all made possible by our very generous corporate sponsors that definitely deserve a mention once again. So, Phil and Michael at Fleckney Autofix Limited, Danielle at Social Graph Limited, Mick and Kev at Deenethorpe Aerodrome, Guy at storing.com, John at JPH Steelworks Limited, Brian at Dealey Floor Preparation, Nathan at Spender's Motorcycles, Graham and Dave at GS Aviation Limited, SkyDemon and Maincor Limited. Thank you all so much. So we are now getting very close to Deenethorpe, and we're about to line up for a synchronised approach side by side for a flyby. Very welcoming. Landing lights going on before I forget it.
Yeah, I've got the lights on, I've got the camera working.
Deenethorpe traffic, golf, 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 Tango Romeo, final 04, Deenethorpe. That's it, we're down. That's the end of it. Morning all.
Morning, Chris.
How are we doing?
Chris, get out of the bloody way. Oh.
The road is long. My brother. he ain't heavy. He's my brother. It's a long, long road. From which there is no return. While we're on the way to there, why not share? My brother.